And as time flies by, you'll open up your eyes wide. You feel it's gonna go your way. Hey, hey, it's a brand new day. Hey, 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 it's a brand new day.
Welcome back to Marbella Now. My name is Nicole King, and again this week we're going to take you on a tour around our very diverse city to make sure that you get to see some of the most emblematic and interesting places our city has to offer. We're starting off the programme here at the promenade in front of our tourist office, which is a very important place not only for tourists but for local residents to know more about the things going on in our fabulous city.
It's a brand new day. Hey, hey, hey. It's a brand new day. Halfway twisted, you've been out of shape, and you feel like you've missed it. You dropped out the race, and it's time.
Undoubtedly, one of the busiest people this summer has to be our tourism councillor, Miguel Luna, entrusted with this job by the mayor himself, Jose Bernal. Obviously, a very important mission to keep that affluent tourist coming to Marbella year after year. Good morning, Miguel.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm very excited to finally have a chance to chat with you. Mm-hmm. You must have had a very, very busy summer.
Of course, we have a fantastic summer. I think it's a historic summer, and Marbella is full.
You must be so proud, because you've only been in the position for just over a year. Mm-hmm. There's a lot that happens in Marbella, so to keep up and adding, and everything to have turned out so perfectly, mm-hmm. I mean, it's quite an achievement. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. And then, well, we have a tourist office now. It's open every day. Including the Sunday, Saturday, every day. And then we have the palace.
The exhibition center.
Exhibition center is every day have something. We have something there. And then events, concerts. Mar Anthony, Passion Vega now, Rafael, and many, many artists we have too in Marbella.
What's it like meeting such famous people? Mm-hmm. Is it nice? Is it now part of your day-to-day?
Yes, of course. Now we have many, many, many important people in Marbella, and I don't have time. 24 hours, I think, we work, because we are the night and morning all day. But Marbella is the more important place in the Europe, in the south of Europe, the coast.
Without a doubt, and every year we get more and more established. Last year at the important Spanish tourist fair, Fitur, Marbella for the first time in a long time had its own stand. Mm-hmm. That was a big step on part of the town hall.
Yes, that's it. Well, last year in Fitur, we stayed with a stand. Marbella go with a stamp.
Its own stand, yes.
Exactly. And then we stay in Berlin too, with a stand too. And then next year we are going to Fitur, Berlin, London, Dubai and Moscow.
So obviously it's been very successful.
Five fair of the world, the more important.
There's been recently a Kuwait festival here. Mm-hmm. There is a lot of diversity of nationalities mm-hmm. in Marbella.
Yes, well, Kuwait Fair in Antonio Banderas Square in Puerto Banús. We have many visits because this year come many, many, many people from Kuwait. It's the people of Kuwait come again to Marbella because many have a house in Marbella and the rest go to the normally five-star hotel. And now Marbella, we have 7 5-star hotels. We have more 5-star hotels of the rest of the coast, you know. And there is many, many people from Kuwait. And now we have more party from September because August is full, everything. And many concerts, many parties. But now in September, from September, October, November, December, we have many events in Marbella.
It sounds like the party never ends here, but there's a lot more to it than just the partying. The organization mm-hmm. of this is tremendous, but these names coming to Marbella must bring also so many extra tourists. There's a lot of events going on,
of course,
to keep Marbella an all year round season, which is the objective.
Yeah, we are working to have a high season till the end of October, and this is possible 15th of November. But we work with events and congress from September, and we have many at the moment with the exhibition center in the entrance of Marbella, and tourists. I have 25 people work about tourists in Marbella. And
this office is amazing because you really can, well, the various office, tourist yeah. offices and all the different zones of Marbella, Las Chapas, Nueva Andalucía, San Pedro, but this one here in Marbella is so emblematic.
And the harbour, Puerto Banús.
And in Puerto Banús.
And now in about 1 month we have another one, the new one, in the bus station.
The new bus station, because that's been completely redone. It looks very nice.
We signed with the people of the Avanza, and the people give us a place to open a tourist office there, because many people come from the airport through with the bus, and from the AVE from Madrid with the bus, and Madrid bus too.
That'll be a big help.
It's one of the entrance of the Marbella.
Fabulous news. We were just chatting before, and a nice dog walked past us, and asked Miguel if he liked dogs, and he said yes. And in fact, just to remind you that there is a fabulous dog show event coming up at the exhibition center this very weekend. Mm-hmm. So it's like a big, a trade fair mm-hmm. for everything you need for dogs.
Exactly. It's the next week. Friday, Saturday and Sunday, and I think it's the more strong about dog in Spain.
Fabulous.
Yes.
Because we have so many dog lovers here, that our local community is going to love this.
If any people like to have more information, please contact with any tourist office or the exhibition center. And then we have one of the day, the first day, we are going walking with the dog, with our dog, from Puente Romano to the Congress, to the Exhibition Center, through the Paseo Marítimo.
Oh, that's going to be so much fun.
I invite from here all the people like to come with us to work with our dogs.
I'm sure you'll have a lot of people there because we do love our dogs. Talk about that every Saturday, remember, you can go and walk one of the AAA dogs that need it so much. Some 450 dogs waiting for Saturday, and all of us, community, whatever nationality you are, to go and help walk all those dogs. Mm-hmm. Before we finish, Miguel, I have to ask you, where are you from?
Well, I am from here, from Marbella, and I work first in a hotel, 5-star hotel in Marbella, Marbella Club Hotel, 25 years, and now I have 18 years in the tourist office. And now, well, the mayor of Marbella, José Bernal, gave me this responsibility to with the tourists in Marbella, and exhibition center, and event, concert, because many years before, I worked with Michael Jackson, Tina Turner, Joey Cocker, Simple Minds, Simple Red.
Through the hotel?
Yes, well, through the company. Outside of the hotel, uh-huh. I worked with the company in this concert.
Wow, he certainly made a good decision. From what I see, a lot of you who are now in the town hall grew up in Marbella, so you must be friends from schools. It must be nice to be able to play a role mm-hmm. in the your city where you grew up. You've seen a lot of changes in Marbella.
A lot of changes, of course. Now, well, when I work in tourism, when I am a boy, my first work is bellboy in Marbella Club Hotel, 14 years, 1-4 only. And then it's a small town, very small, very many famous people come 42 years ago. You know, Prince Alfonso Eloe is the first owner of Marbella Club, come with the Hollywood people, many, many people, important people from Hollywood come to Marbella. Very small town, but now it's, of course, it's very big. You know? But I remember this Marbella is fantastic. Now it's fantastic too, of course. And now we are changed. I put five-star place. Marbella is a five-star place because five-star is similar of the rich people.
Quality.
Exactly.
Excellence.
Excellent. This is the name. And for that now we are changed. Every day we change and the hotel is full, everything is full. And many people like to come again to Marbella. Many people from many years ago don't come, but now arrive again to Marbella.
Well, it's wonderful. You're doing an excellent job. And mm-hmm. I have to say, it's amazing to speak to Miguel because he's in the excitement that you talk about what you do. I can wish you many years of success. Thank you very much for everything you
You're
do
welcome.
To make our lives so absolutely wonderful.
And we are here to help the people visit Marbella or live here in Marbella because we have a very, very, very important tourist residential, you know. People live in Marbella from different countries and have opened our doors to come here. Any information about the exhibition center, events, we have 20 people in Marbella, Puerto Banús, San Pedro, La Chapas, in all the place to help the people live in Marbella.
And if you're living in Marbella, I know the town hall would love you to sign up on the town register. A lot of people associate this with taxes, but as I understand it, this is nothing to do with taxes. It is just something that lets the town hall know how many people are living in the area to make sure you get your garbage collection, that you're kept safe, and that you have the medical assistance you need, plus you get some good deductions on taxes.
That's it.
So, I mean, it's really worthwhile to sign up onto the town census, mm-hmm. and it just helps you guys look after us better.
And please call us, it's very important. The people, we have people here speak English, French, German, Holland, all the country.
And website as well, we've got marbellaexclusive.com, and as Miguel's saying, you've got all the different languages there that you can click to find out all this
of
information.
Course, any information.
About getting your car MOT'd in Spain, about getting your residency, all the information you need is there in your language for you.
Mm-hmm. Of course.
Any last messages, Miguel, to our viewers? Well, so happy to have you on the show. People
well,
get to see
it's
you.
Only to tell the people, we are very happy to with our city. My city is your city, you know, it's Marbella is for the whole world. And thank you very much for this.
Miguel agreed with me that we would do the interview in Spanish, and I don't know if you realised, you've just done the whole interview in English, and
in English.
I salute you. That was
thank you
excellent.
Very much.
Absolutely fabulous.
Okay.
Thank you, Miguel.
Thank you very much. Have a good day.
Hi, well, welcome back to the What's On slot. Well, we're nearly waving goodbye to another fantastic summer here in Marbella. We've had record amounts of visitors here for all the restaurants and different businesses and including the hotel. But as we say goodbye to the summer tourists, it's hello to the autumn guests. Now, I love all the different seasons here in Marbella, spring being one of my favourite, along with autumn. So let's go on and enjoy and see what's going on then. So we have a new exhibition which is actually opening this evening at the Casa Rasu Gallery, that's opposite the Marbella Club here in Marbella, and this is called Objects of Desire. It runs until the 26th of September, and it's a fusion of two very different artists, the first one being Luis Toroba and Elena Orad. Now, these two artists have adapted their type of sort of pop art, inspired by the coast and various luxury items, objects of desire here that we have in Marbella. So it should be very interesting to see how they've interpreted our town. Now, something for you antique and vintage collector lovers. There's an antiques fair again started today and runs till Sunday at the Palacio de Congresos here in Marbella. Entrance is only €3 and the hours on Saturday and Sunday are 12 o'clock midday to midnight. Now you can enjoy all sorts of different antiques, collectibles, vintage objects for everyone that loves something just that little bit different to adorn your house. Now the first charity run of autumn starts on Sunday to benefit Crethe, who help children and families with special needs. Now this leaves the football field at the Hacienda Nagueles, goes along the Paseo and into the fishing port, goes round back along the Paseo and back up to the football field. So do go along and support them. They should start around about 9 o'clock in the morning. Now, a late arrival from the town hall for this week, from yesterday until Saturday, enjoy the Feria del Sol here in the Avenida del Mar. That's the avenue with all the Dali statues behind the Alameda Park. Now, this is an adaptation of the famous 60s festival, which was called the Week of the Sun. And it's intended to capture the essence of fun and which everyone thought of doing in the 60s in all sorts of different ways. But this particular one is to say goodbye to basically the summer holidays. So we can get, you'll get from 7 o'clock each night, you'll get singing, dancing, live music, food, all sorts of different entertainment. So we'll see you there. And hopefully Brian might even dust off his Feria flowers for yet another one. So we'll enjoy seeing you there. So a couple of things to come up for your diaries for you to note is the Beefy Free Festival this year is from the 1st to the 4th of September. Big parties, DJs, leisure, cultural and social activities. The site has got a lot of information for you with the full programme and all the information and links for tickets as well. Now the dog show and fair that's taking place between the 2nd and the 4th of September, again in the Palacio de Congresos here in Marbella, will offer you different shows and things from the canine unit of the Guardia Civil. They're marvellous, those dogs, and they really will entertain you. You'll also be able to enjoy Samba. Now, if you don't know Samba, you'll get to know him at this show and fair. He's a very, very famous dog. Along with showing your dogs, they can partake into the best pose, they can maybe the best fashion outfit, all sorts of different, very easygoing, light dog show entertainment. Now there'll be lots of different stands there for everything that you need for your pets and their care. Acupuncture, natural therapies, these are not for you, these are for your animals. Animal communication and of course Reiki for your pets, which I understand are very good. We used to use Reiki on the horses and much, much more. So it all starts with a dog walk from on the Friday from the Puente Romano Hotel, and that goes along to the Palacio, and they're leaving about 9:30, so it's not too hot for the dogs. There's also a charity dinner, and there's lots of information on the site on how you can get tickets and also enter into any of the shows that you want to. Now the last thing I have is the Gibraltar Music Festival. We hope you've all got your tickets. This is only on the 3rd and the 4th of September, and they do go very quick. So get in if you haven't. There's full links and everything on the site for you, along with lots of information on some of the acts that you'll enjoy. The likes of Stereophonics, Neo and Travis, Brian Ferry will be there, along with Europe. Do you remember that from Final Countdown? And of course, All Saints. So do go along and enjoy that. It was a wonderful success last year. So that's all I have for you this week. And hopefully you can check out any more of the events and lots of others on the website marbellazul.com, and I'll have a great weekend. I'll see you next week.
Hey, it's a brand new day. dropped out the race. And
we've come up now to the Calle Jacinto Benavente, which is the same street in Marbella that the main post office is on. But above the old town in Marbella, we come up here to the central market, which is a very important area for those who live in Marbella. But maybe it's not such a well-known place for us tourists, but certainly well worth a visit. There are several entrances. I believe the main entrance is on the other side. We'll leave that way to show you. But we're going to go in from this door right here.
Open up your eyes wide. You know it's gonna go your way. Hey, hey, it's a brand new day. Hey, 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 it's a brand new day.
Jose Maria, better known to his friends as their Nene the Malaga. It's also the name of this store. And this is where not only you can get your amazingly fresh fish, but they also turn that into very, very fresh sushi right here. Jose Maria, thank you for sharing a few minutes.
¿Qué tal? Buenos días.
Buenos días. Where are you from? ¿De dónde eres?
Yo soy de Málaga. Lo dice el nombre, el Nene de Málaga, soy de Málaga.
It's authentic Málaga produce, and here everything is very fresh, but you took one step further and learned how to make sushi. Has llevado el puesto un paso más para aprender incorporar a sushi aquí en el,
sí,
en el puesto.
Sí, la verdad es que sí, pero el sushi yo ya lo hacía desde hace bastante tiempo. Empecé en el primer restaurante que pusieron de sushi en Marbella, que era mi amigo Conish, restaurante Katsura, detrás de Siebla. Eso ya no existe porque él falleció. Y después he tenido la oportunidad de, en el 88 fui a Okinawa 9 meses a aprender bonsai, y allí aprendí el sushi tradicional japonés de verdad, el ancestro.
Well, he may be the Nene of Malaga, and he may have been born here, but his first experience with sushi was thanks to a friend of his who opened up the first sushi restaurant in Marbella, Conis. And then he went to Okinawa to learn about the bonsai trees, and then he really got his hand in it, and then brought all this back here to Marbella, traditional Andaluz,
total,
incorporating that fabulous international flair.
Sí, porque ahora hace no mucho, en invierno, pues el año pasado estuve introduciendo esto en un restaurante de aquí de San Pedro, en el Ancla del Oro, metí el sushi, también en los trocaderos lo había puesto antes también, y después pues hablando con Pepe Bernal, el alcalde actual, me dijo que porque no hacíamos algo atractivo para el mercado y tal, y pensamos en poner unos pocos de bar y tal, y ponernos al día como otros mercados de España y hacer una diversidad de ofertas al cliente.
Well, absolutely fabulous. What he's saying is that obviously starting off with the sushi so many years ago, but now having
Hola,
chatted with Jose Bernal, today's mayor of Marbella, suggested to the Nene the Malaga, Malaga's baby boy, that he bring that little bit of flair into the actual traditional market, and that's exactly what they've done. Well, we're going to meet some more people here in the market. Jose Maria is going to prepare some sushi, and we'll pop back to take a look. Vamos a dar una vuelta y volvemos a ver.
Ahora hacemos un par de platos, claro que sí, lo hacemos in situ ya.
Fantástico, thank you.
De Sounds nada, cool. Hasta ahora, buenos días.
Hey, hey, it's a brand new day. Hey, hey, it's a brand new day.
Some of the stall owners here at the market seem to think that not even the Spanish people know that this place exists, even less for us foreigners. So I'm really happy that we get an opportunity to walk around today and show you all these fabulous stalls that offer such varieties from saffron, vegetables, fruit, even that sushi. And I've just seen here we've got an ecological stand, and guess who's standing at it? Juan Carlos Berenguer. Let's go and say hello.
What are you doing here?
I am here filming the market, and I couldn't believe I've seen you. What are you doing here?
Well, I'm with my friend Vicente.
Hello, Vicente.
Hi, how are you doing, Nicole?
Are you from this stand? Is this yours?
Yes, this is our business, yes. Well, we have an organic retail business here. We do predominantly home deliveries, but we also have a base here at the Marbella Central Market, so people can actually come and shop themselves.
Wow, where are you from with that wonderful English accent?
I'm from Hamburg in Germany.
Hamburg in Germany, you sound like you're from Oxford in England.
Well, it's very close, it's just a very short distance.
Huh? And how long have you been in Marbella?
I've been living in Marbella for about 20 years and I've been in Spain for over 30.
Wow, do you speak Spanish?
Naturally, yes.
Naturally, yes. Very, obviously, because he's German, not English.
That's very strange, because there are lots of English, they've been living here for 30 years and they just know cerveza, por favor, la cuenta.
Mantequilla.
I lived for 15 years in Madrid, and there you have to speak Spanish or you don't get by. So therefore, when I came to Spain, I was sent here on business, had to open an office for a publishing company, and that obviously made me speak Spanish. My wife is Spanish, and we are very much integrated into this world here.
Well, absolutely wonderful. And it's lovely to see you here in the market, real like in with the Spanish people. Juan Carlos is another Spaniard who's very international. What are you up to these days? I haven't seen you since we came to see you at Volubilis a few weeks ago.
Yeah. Well, now, you know this place in Puerto Banús called Eating Banús?
I was there the other night, actually.
Oh,
great,
really?
Live music, wonderful international foods.
Okay, so we are preparing different things to do in that place, because it's a fantastic place. And one of the ideas is to do, for me, it's going to be the best organic market in the Costa, in the whole Costa.
On a permanent basis or a temporary?
We're just going to do, at the beginning, once a month. It's going to be on Sunday. And we want everything to be organic. Clothes, makeup, fruits, all meat, all sorts of things. At the same time, you can eat there if you want. There is a children's area and good music, and it's going to be a special thing.
And when's this starting off?
We're going to start it in October, because we need at least 1 month.
So that area, Eating Banús, is going to be a permanent fixture?
Of course, during the whole year.
I thought it was just for the summer.
No. It's going to be during the whole year. But they don't want just a place serving food. They want to do more activities and more things here in the winter. So one of the ideas, I was with them yesterday, and one of the ideas is just to promote a real good organic market.
Well, there certainly is a demand for it. At the United Nationalities meeting on the 5th of April, one of the main subjects was having an organic market here in Marbella, and to be able to show off wares such as yours, it looks fabulous. So how long have you had this stall in the market?
We have been in this business for the past 7 years. We've opened this here as a base 2 years ago, because it serves us as a base of logistics. Most of our business is home deliveries, and we have customers from all over the world, between Malaga and Gibraltar, and we do a lot of home deliveries. And since we started, we have always been very careful about maintaining our internet presence, and therefore most people searching for organic fruit or organic vegetables or organic meat will find us and do their online shopping.
Well, I'm very glad we found you too, and I'm very glad to have bumped into you, young man. You'll have to come on another program and tell us more about the exciting project.
Whenever you want. Yeah, and from today, we're going to have a small place at the beginning of a normal market that you can buy clothes, jewelry, all sorts of different things in eating banus.
Wonderful. Well, we'll see you there.
Yeah, please.
Okay,
come.
I'm really glad to have bumped into you. Oh. Smiling faces and lovely to have met you, sir.
It's been a pleasure.
Absolutely
bye-bye.
Mine.
All the right.
It's a great place here. So I'm having a good time.
Bye-bye.
Best of luck.
You'll open up your eyes wide. You know it's gonna go your way.
A very good evening to you. Welcome to the Mercado Central here in Marbella. I'm Patrick Grant, your legal beagle, and this week I have had a question from John, who wanted to know what to do in the event of a death in Spain. Now, for the next few minutes, I'm going to be concentrating on tourists and non-residents of Spain. That's because people who live here and people who have the language have a much clearer idea of what to do in the event that this happens. Now, there are two absolutely key things to remember, first of all, in this situation. And number one is having a good travel insurance policy. And that's for reasons I'm going to explain in a minute. Number two is, before you come away, is making sure that you've got the number of your local consulate or embassy. In the Malaga region, we have every single nationality, as you've probably seen on the show, represented as a consulate, and you can call them 24 hours a day for any emergency assistance. So, when you're dealing with a death in Spain, it depends very much on the scenario. If, for example, somebody dies in hospital, the hospital are going to be able to deal with a huge amount of what happens without you probably having to do very much. They will have people who have been in this situation before and can assist you. But if the death is unexpected or at home or outside of the home while you're traveling around, then these are the steps that you need to follow. The very first thing to do is to call the police on 092. You can explain to them in English, because their operators speak English, exactly what has happened. And following that, don't touch anything. Just wait for the emergency services to arrive. Once they do, the police will explain to you exactly what you need to do in those circumstances. It is highly likely, if the death is unexpected, and just to warn you, that the body may be there for quite a considerable amount of time, because a judge will need to come and look at it, as well as a doctor, to establish the exact cause of death. This is something connected to the European Convention on Human Rights, which means that the state needs to investigate any death which might be slightly suspicious or, as I say, unexpected. If the police don't do so, you're going to need to call a doctor. Again, you can get hold of a doctor fairly easily by either looking on Google or calling directory inquiries here in Spain. A doctor will come and he will issue a death certificate. Now, at any stage in these proceedings, it's highly advisable to call your local consulate. That means if you're British, the British consul. That means if you're Danish, the Danish consul. They have dealt with this before, they will deal with this again, and they are extraordinarily helpful and sympathetic to your needs. When a doctor arrives, he will examine the body and he will give a death certificate. This is an extremely important document and you need to keep hold of this. It sets out, rather like a birth certificate or a passport, just all of the details of the deceased person and a probable cause of death. It is massively important for what's going to come up next. The next thing you're going to be asked to do, and your consul should assist you with this, is register the death in Spain. You will need to take the death certificate along with you that the doctor has signed, and anybody with the knowledge of the person who has died can do this. But it must be done in 24 hours of the death, and make sure you do that. Again, and I keep specifying this, if you're having any difficulties in this situation, speak to your local consulate, they will help. Now, things move slightly quicker in Spain than perhaps in Northern Europe we might be used to. Funerals or cremations tend to take place within 24 to 48 hours. So, if you want to bring the deceased person back to the country that you live in, you need to get onto that very quickly. And this is where a travel insurance policy comes in. The word you're looking for here is repatriation of a body. And if you have good travel insurance, this tends to be dealt with by the travel insurance company. So they're another bunch of people that you need to alert in the event that anything like this occurs. The travel insurance company will be able to tell you exactly which flight to take, exactly how to deal with transporting the body. Now, When a body is being repatriated, it needs its passport. So make sure that you have that passport to hand and it is with the body for the repatriation. Again, your travel company will be able to assist you with this, but just make sure that you're trying to move quickly on this because, as I say, it can cause a huge amount of difficulties trying to move a body out of Spain after 48 hours have elapsed. So, let's just recap this because it's very, very important. In the event that somebody who is a tourist or a non-resident of Spain dies in hospital, this should be dealt with by the hospital and they will know exactly what to do. In the event that it is not in a hospital, it's at home, outside the home, or it's unexpected, you need to report it to the police immediately, and that's 092. Explain to the operator what's happened, and the police and the emergency services will be with you as soon as possible. Do not be shocked if they leave a body lying around for a period of time. This is because there needs to be an investigation, as I explained. During this time, you should contact your local consulate or embassy and inform them of exactly what has happened and the details of the deceased. Finally, repatriation. Make sure you speak to either the consulate or to your travel insurance company and get the exact details of how this is going to happen. Again, in the event that this happens to you, most companies, the police included, and doctors are hugely, hugely sympathetic here in Spain to this kind of issue. And we'll be able to advise you, point you in the right direction, and make sure that this traumatic time is dealt with as quickly and as easily as is humanly possible. That's it for this week. If you have any questions, please drop me a line, patrick.charles.grant@gmail.com, and I'll do my best to help you out. Until then, stay safe, have a great weekend, and we'll see you next time. Take care, Marbella.
A lot of people prefer to take their own car when going out at night. However, when it comes to time to go home, that might not be the safest or wisest option. For some, just one glass of wine could put you over the legal limit, which means if you drive, you could put yourself or others at risk, not to mention the controls. So, as we're expats living on the coast, this can be a dilemma, because that's what we do. We go out, we try the wines. And that's why Línea Directa have gone above and beyond with this new completely free bonus policy to people who take out car insurance with them. If you're an expat and live in Malaga, then you get to get all the benefit of this trial of safety first people, a free bonus policy for anyone insuring their car with Línea Directa. But what does this mean? That means that if you find yourself in this dilemma and think possibly you should not be driving, you can just give Línea Directa a call. They will order and pay for a taxi, which will take you and your fellow companions who were with you in the car home with up to a 25-kilometer radius, as long as you all fit in that one taxi and you're all going to the same place. You can even ask for them to pick up your car and take that back too. And this is 7 days a week from midnight to 7 a.m. and up to 4 times a month. And this is obviously all in addition to the fabulous insurance that you get with Línea Directa. Being a Spanish company, they cover you by all the local Spanish laws. Plus, they have a fleet of tow trucks, mechanics, garages, hotels, lawyers, whatever you need. Línea Directa truly do cater to our expats' needs. And all we can say is yes, thank you very much. This is a really nice option to make sure we keep ourselves very safe. If you want more information on this, please go to their website, lineadirector.com, or call them on 952 14 78 34. That's 952 14 78 34, because Línea Directa are putting your safety first.
So you're a business on the Costa del Sol, and you know the best way to reach customers is through word of mouth. But how can you reach more people to grow your business even faster? Before you spend a lot of money on advertising that may never reach your customers, find out how MarbellaFamilyFun.com can help spread the word about your business today. MarbellaFamilyFun.com.
Good afternoon. We're here in the market in Marbella, And with me, I have a volunteer from AAA who we met a little while ago. And this is Sylvia. Sylvia had a dream, and she's coming here to explain to us what her dream is. Welcome, Sylvia.
Thank you.
You have a dream.
Yes.
What's your dream?
My dream is to open up a cat cafe in Marbella. A cat cafe will be a place where you can go and visit, have a nice cup of coffee, have a nice piece of cake, and then enjoy cats. All the cats are adoptable. And then you can experience what it is to be with cats without any responsibility or any obligation.
And how did you get an idea of opening a cat cafe in Marbella?
I think I was watching TV and saw something on TV coming by and some pictures of Japanese cat cafes. And it just, I couldn't get it out of my head anymore. It was in my head and I wanted to open that.
And there are more cat cafes in the world? I presume there's many already?
Yes, there are loads, there are loads. It opened up in Taiwan, and then in Japan there are about 150. In Europe there are more than 20 already. And in Spain we have one in Madrid and one in Barcelona.
And this would be the third one here in Marbella?
And the first in Andalusia.
And the first in Andalusia. And the cats are adoptable, you say? You're working together with AAA to get the cats there?
Yes, I'll be working with AAA, and all the cats that we're going to have are adoptable. So if you do get this link, this connection with one of the cats while you're having a nice cup of coffee, then you are able to adopt that cat, yes.
But as I understand it, it's not, it is like a charity, it is another purpose. It has another purpose than just petting the cats and playing with the cats. What else will you do there?
True. That's very, very true. In Spain, they call it an educational and therapy center because we want to raise awareness on wellness of cats. And here in Spain, there's a bit of lack of love for cats. People love dogs, but they don't know about cats. So it's a place where you can actually get to know the cats. It's all non-profit. So there's no way that anybody's going to get rich out of this. It's a beautiful non-profit project. It really comes right out of my heart. And yeah, that's about it. You can learn about cats.
So it's also an educational center.
Absolutely. We want to work also with 12-year-old school children, invite them to come over and enjoy some time with the cats, and so that they can know what it is to have a cat and to be with a cat and all those health benefits that a cat purr gives us. I mean, we get really happy from them. It's endorphin that gets released and you get happy of it. It calms you down. If you are depressive, you should come because it makes you happy. No more sad moments. And you have a friend. A cat is a real, real friend.
And you have already a location. It is not totally built yet.
No.
Of course, are you going to sponsor this yourself? Do you have backers? How are you going to get this dream realized financially?
Right. I wish I could do it all by myself. That would be the easiest way, but I cannot. I will have to do it through crowdfunding. Crowdfunding is micro donations by loads and loads of people. You can donate and then get a nice perk as a compensation for your donation. So that's the way I want to do it. We've seen a place which is perfect for it, but it does need some adjustments. And, that costs a lot of money, unfortunately.
So what you're basically doing is asking the public to sponsor you or to sponsor the cat cafe.
Exactly.
There is a crowdfunding page that they can go to. It will be on your website.
Yeah, the easiest way would be to go to www.catcafemarbella.com, and then you will see three videos, one in Spanish, one in English, and one in Dutch. If you look at those videos halfway, they'll be in the left hand or the right hand corner. There'll be a place where it says, if you want to support this campaign, pinch here or click here. If you do that, you go directly to the crowdfunding campaign. And that's where it all shows itself. I mean, there you can make a donation, choose a nice nice perk, and get absolutely lovely gifts.
And you're needing a certain amount of money, of course, to realize all this. And the crowdfunding is, of course, a very safe way of collecting money, because if you do not reach your goal, then the people who have sponsored the money or have pledged the money, they will, if they wish, they can have their money back because you're not getting the goal. But of course, your dream has to come true. We all have to make it come through.
Absolutely.
So even after the crowdfunding program would start or would finish, you will go on and you will look for sponsors and people to back you up.
Exactly. The crowdfunding campaign that we have got active right now is Indiegogo.com. It's in the one of the biggest crowdfunding platforms, and it all goes through PayPal or by credit card. You can pay through PayPal or by credit card. PayPal and credit card through the Indiegogo platform is the most secure way that I can collect money from people, because they know that I will only use it for the cat cafe. If I do not reach the goal for the funding goal, if I don't get it all together with before the 30th of September, every single cent will be returned to the collaborator, the person that have actually supported the campaign. Every single cent will go back. Then, if that doesn't work, I will try to find another way that we can collect enough money, because I have noticed that there are so many people that really think that this place, Cat Cafe Marbella, needs to be a reality. It needs to be there. We need it here in Marbella.
Well, thank you very much. It is wonderful talking to you. And I really do hope that you will get your dream come true, because, of course, animals are also my love, cats and dogs. And I know how much the cats are your life, and that you will give your everything to get this cat cafe going. So please support her. Go to the website. It will be mentioned underneath. Go to support her. Look what a cat cafe is all about. And good luck.
It's not only my dream. And thank you. Thank you very much for having me here.
You're welcome. And of course, AAA will be present at the next dog event next weekend. Nicole talked about it earlier in the show. AAA will have a table there, and you can come and visit us and donate or buy an item and see everything about AAA. It's a big dog event in Marbella, and we'd love to see you there.
I'll be there.
And remember, don't shop, adopt.
Like our wines, us foreigners, and what better place to be in Spain than to try on the wines. In fact, there's a word, cata, which means a tasting of wine, and here in the market you've got a lovely business called Catando, which is tasting. And not only do you get to taste fabulous wines, which we'll hear more about with Salvador in a second, but to accompany those fabulous wines, on this side we have some amazing sushi, and that's prepared by Sebastian. Hello, hola.
Hola, buenas.
So, Sebastian, I hear you don't speak English, nada de inglés.
No, poquito, poquito, nada, vamos.
So, do you get many foreigners here in the market? ¿Hay algún turista que venga al mercado o pocos?
Sí, vienen algunos turistas de vez en cuando, van pasando por las mañanas, van paseando, van mirando, van viendo, se llevan algunas cositas también. Y van comprando poquito a poco y
we're saying that some foreigners do make it in here to the market. We come in the mornings, have a walk around. You're here representing this company, Catando. You do amazing sushi. Do you make it yourself?
Sí, yo hago el sushi yo mismo para tomar aquí o para llevar, como prefieran.
It's a very international thing, sushi, and you're very Spanish. Es una cosa muy internacional lo del sushi, eres muy español. ¿Por dónde entraste en este mundo? How did you come to being a sushi maker?
Yo empecé trabajando el sushi para varios restaurantes, ¿no? Que tenían algo, tenían un poquito de comida japonesa o preparábamos algo. Y entonces, a raíz de ahí, hice un curso también un poco para iniciarme en lo que es el sushi. Nosotros también hacemos talleres de sushi, ¿eh? Para empezar un poquito lo que es el maki, lo que es el osomaki, lo que es cocer el arroz. Y entonces, a partir de ahí, una cosa que me gusta también, me gusta el sushi. Entonces fui creciendo y fui aprendiendo lo que es el sushi, ¿vale? Y fuimos perfeccionándonos, ¿eh? Hasta llegar al momento de lo que hacemos.
Well, it's absolutely wonderful. This youngster here says he likes sushi himself. He started off learning how to make sushi in various different restaurants. Then he went and did a course, and today he is here in charge of this sushi puesto. You're from where? ¿De dónde eres?
Yo de aquí, de Marbella.
Sí, a very local Marbella boy, but involved in international. ¿Cómo has ido creciendo con guiris alrededor? What's been like growing up with so many foreigners around you?
Bueno, vamos creciendo, ¿no? Yo siempre he vivido aquí en Marbella y siempre la hostelería siempre se ha, se ha regido aquí por el tema del turismo y el tema del extranjero aquí en Marbella, entonces no ha sido una cosa difícil tampoco.
It hasn't been difficult growing up with us foreigners. In fact, it's because of all the restaurants and bars here in Marbella that gives them the opportunity to then get into that culinary world, specializing in sushi. Well, Sebastian, thank you very much. Can we take a little look? Vamos a echar un vistazo a tus
perfecto,
preparativos.
Perfecto, como queráis.
Dropped out the race, and as time flies by, you'll open up your eyes wide. You feel it's gonna go your way. Hey, hey, it's a brand new day. Hey, 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 it's a brand new day. Falls in place, and you feel like you're lifted to where angels lay, but it's time flies by.
Well, now that we've seen some wonderful sushi being made and met Sebastian, I'm going to come over to the wine side of Catando to test some wines, or at least to find out what it's all about. Salvador, we just met Sebastian and he said he likes sushi and he likes making it. Que le gusta sushi, le gusta hacer sushi. Do you like wine? ¿Te gusta el vino?
Sí, me gusta mucho.
Are you a connoisseur? ¿Eres un sabiondo de los vinos?
Bueno, sabiondo no, nunca se sabe de todo. Yo soy un aficionado y me gusta bastante. Llevo algún tiempo ya en el mundo del vino. Y nunca se termina de aprender todo. Siempre se va aprendiendo más.
Well, Salvador was saying that although he does like wines and he learned a lot, you can never know everything, and this is definitely a work in progress, learning everything. But he likes what he does. ¿Qué tipo de vinos tenéis aquí? What type of wines do you have here in Catando?
Pues tenemos aproximadamente unas 350 referencias diferentes.
350 different references.
Tenemos vinos blancos, rosados, tintos, vinos jóvenes con un poquito de madera. Vinos de reserva, tenemos blancos también con un poquito de madera, los blancos jóvenes de la zona de aquí de Málaga, un poquito de casi todas las regiones de España.
Well, they've got wines from all over the different regions in Spain, and they've got white wines even with that wooden flavor of the wood of the barrel, and they cover basically everything, particularly Spanish wines, which is very nice. ¿Cuál es tu preferido? ¿Cuál te gusta más? What's your favorite?
Uy, tengo varios. Tengo algunos vinos de Alicante que me gustan mucho, de aquí de Málaga también. También tengo, es que como me gusta tanto el vino, realmente decir que tengo un favorito no podría decirlo, porque cada vino tiene su cosa y tiene su peculiaridad.
What Salvador's saying is he can't choose one particular favorite wine. There's various that he really likes, one from Alicante, another one here from Malaga. But because he understands and likes wine so much, obviously there is a different wine for each occasion. Se dice pescado con vino blanco, carne, tinto. Are these set rules that you have to have white wine with fish and red wine with meat?
Eso realmente no tiene por qué ser así. Depende del tipo de pescado que vayan a tomar. Si es un pescado muy graso, un vino tinto también le va muy bien. En el caso de la carne, pues también hay vinos blancos que pueden ir muy bien para una carne blanca, una carne más suave.
So he's saying that this white wine with fish isn't necessarily the case, because there are certain greasy fishes, for example, that a red wine goes really well with, and the same way you've got white meats that are very nice with a white wine. How long has this puesto been open, this stall been open? ¿Cuánto tiempo lleváis en este puesto?
Pues aproximadamente un año y medio.
So for a year and a half they've been offering wines here, not just to the public that you can come and have a glass of wine and taste, but also to the restaurants and bar. No solamente que se puede venir a tomar algo aquí, pero suministráis a los negocios en la zona.
También, los negocios que quieran nuestro servicio estamos aquí dispuestos. También vendemos a domicilio, entregamos a domicilio. Los vinos que tenemos aquí en tienda también los podemos servir aquí en mesa al cliente al mismo precio, sin cobrar ningún tipo de descorche. En definitiva, lo que queremos es que el público pruebe el vino y se acostumbre a consumir el vino, porque realmente es un producto 100% natural y en definitiva es una cultura que poco a poco va aumentando porque antiguamente siempre bebían vino las personas mayores y gracias a Dios poco a poco la gente joven pues también vamos entrando en ese hábito de consumo de vino, que es un producto muy rico y natural.
What I was saying is wine is 100% natural, therefore it's good for us, obviously everything in moderation, but that Salvador's very happy to see that the culture of wine is coming back to the youngsters that used to be in the old days in Spain, something that the old people did, but now there's this fashion to drink wines. Like we had years back in England, we had those wine bars taking over from the pubs, but that's a culture they want to obviously support here. So if you would like to come and try wines, come to Catando here in the market, meet Salvador, and I'm sure he'll give you some great advice on wines that can even deliver to your home. Salvador, thank you so much.
Gracias a vosotros.
Salud.
Salud.
Cheers.
It's a brand new day. Life's ways shifted, falls in place, and you feel like you lifted to where angels lay. But it's
with over 40 million cars circulating on our Spanish roads during the month of August, it's very important that we take the basics of driving very seriously to keep ourselves safe. In Marbella, there's 127 different nationalities registered in the town census. That means 127 different nationalities learning to drive different ways and then all meeting up on the Spanish roads. Please, if you've had a drink, do not drive. Ring for a taxi, take a bus, or sleep it off wherever you are, but do not take the car if you've been drinking. And it's important to remember that although we have very long days now in the summer, that it does get dark, and once it's dusk, you need to put your lights on. I can't tell you how many rental cars I've seen, and not rental cars, over the last week that are driving at night time with no lights on. So please do remember that. Plus, if you're going through a tunnel, daytime or nighttime, you must put your lights on all the way through the tunnel. And if you don't, you could be subject to a 90 euro fine, amongst other things. So please take driving very safely, give way to pedestrians, be courteous, be kind, keep safe.
Hey, hey, it's a brand new day.
Now, a place that I really like, and I came for the first time for the Christmas party with Radio Television Marbella, is here to the bar called La Fiesta. Not only is it a typical Spanish bar with amazing tapas, all the locals come here because the prices are great, and the best thing is that if they don't have here what you want, you can buy anything you like from any of these stalls, from the fish, the meat, the vegetables, and bring it here to La Fiesta. And I think it's for €3.50 extra charge. They will cook whatever you chose right here for you, which is amazing. All those lovely lobsters and things that you can get at so much cheaper prices. Let's take a look at La Fiesta.
It's a brand new day. Hey, hey, hey. It's a brand new day.
Well, that's it for another week. Thank you for joining us for Marbella Now 88, recorded last half here in the central market of Marbella. A fabulous place to come, to shop and to eat. Open till 4 in the afternoon. Very cool inside here, I have to say. So another alternative when that hot weather is too much to bear. I'm going to join this table here. We met a lovely gentleman, uncle, and his son-in-law, Xavier. They're from Sevilla, and he sells olives to Tesco, Sainsbury's. So it just shows you lots of opportunities with our local Spanish products. Have yourselves a great week. Take care. We'll see you next week.